In this video, we'll see about the get2 property. Now, get2 property says as get test object property values. So, what exactly are test objects? Objects which are stored as references into your repository. Those are known as test objects. So, before that, I'll just show you here. If I go to resources, object repository, I'll get this dialog box. These are all the objects, and here are the description about the objects given. So if I click on this OK button, you see these are the description properties of this OK button. So these are known as test objects. These are not the actual objects. These are just references given. So if I click on this OK, you see there's one text property which has OK value, dev name property which has this OK button value itself. So now what I want is from this place repository, I want to find out the property values. For this OK button, if I want to find out what is the text value, text property value, so I can use this get2 property, get test object property itself. So I'll just click on close. So any property value you want, you can just select that. Okay, you can find out that and then you can use into your script itself. So I'll just click on close. Now I'll just give an example how to get test object property values. Though the name says as get2 property, it will not get the property, it will get property values. Okay, so you can see here. In the previous video, if you remember, we have seen for the get RO property, runtime object property, same I'll get for the get2 property. There is very slight difference. Instead of RO, that is runtime object, I've written as TO, test object property. This is the property name and I want value of this property, right? I've written as which button I want for this button, that is OK button. I want the property that is text. I want the value of that. So let us see that. Resources object repository OK button. Now if you observe, there are two properties, text and the value is given as OK. I want the same value. Okay, it is given as text. I want same value as OK. There's one more value given as dev name and it is OK button, right? So first we'll focus on this text and I want the answer as OK. I'll just click on close. If you want the answer, you have to store into some variable. This is WPF window, I've get it, and I've stored the value into a variable as B. And I'll display the value in the variable B itself by using message box. So let us see that. Now the syntax is same like for get runtime object property. Okay, get RO property. In double quotes, you have to write the property name, right? I'll just click on this run button and click on run. Yeah. So if you observe here, I've got the answer as OK, which was the same in the object repository, right? So I'll just click on OK. It's working fine. Now I want one more property value, that was dev name. So it was, if in the dev name was the property name and the value was as given as OK button. So what I want is instead of text, I want something else. Yeah. Instead of this text, I want this dev name, that is a property name. I want value of this property, right? That's dev name. So I'll just click on this run button and I'll click on this run. Yeah. So if you see, that is given as OK button, same value which was given in the object repository, OK button. So I'll just click on OK. Just to cross verify, I'll just go back to this object repository, OK button. If you see, there was a dev name given as OK button. So it is working fine. But one thing you have to remember, if the property is not present into your repository, it will not give you the answer. For example, can you see there's no height in this property, in this object repository? OK button, there is no height property and value. So if you write here as I want height value, it will not give you the value, right? So whatever objects you have, whatever values, properties you have in this repository, only that you'll get the answer. Apart from that, you'll not get it, right? So I'll just click on close. If you want those properties and then you have, you should have the runtime objects, then you can get this height, width, x position, y position. Here at the max, you'll get only two. The reason two, because in the repository, you have two properties and two values given. Only then you'll get the answer, right? So I hope you're able to understand how to work with the get2 properties. That's all for this video.